What's up guys, it's Takuya here. I'm gonna talk about my freelance developer pricing strategy. I started my freelance career as a full-stack developer 10 years ago in Tokyo, Japan. I'm currently living in Osaka and successfully living off of my SaaS app called Inkdrop. It makes enough profit to live a comfortable and calm life without doing contract jobs. I developed this app while working with clients as a freelancer. It wouldn't have been possible without a solid pricing strategy to maximize the freelance work revenues while minimizing the time for it. I've made $70,000 for contract jobs that I actually worked for only a month. So I'm going to talk about how I accomplished it. The key points in this video are project-based pricing, forget your salary, trust yourself, research the pricing standards in your market, and four criteria to make up your price. So let's get started. The first key is project-based pricing. You should never go with hourly pricing because it wastes your time. It's easy for freelance developers to price themselves with an hourly rate or things like that, and most of them start out with it. Because it's simple and easy, you don't have to have deep negotiations with the client. But that's the pitfall if you want to earn more. You are a software developer, which means that you're not like a crew working at the conveyor belt like a robot. You can be creative to get things done quicker than other people. So you should be tied the price of the project to the client's end result, not to how long you worked for the project. With the project-based fees, you can get more free time, which allows you to take a break and learn more skills and build your own products. You don't necessarily get fewer fees for less work because clients just want the end result, not your time, okay? But how to decide how much to charge for your work? First, you should forget your monthly salary that was paid by a company you have been working at. Because freelancing is completely different from working at a company. Once you become a freelancer, you have to do everything that the company was offering you, such as office, desk chair, and social insurance, welfare benefits, transportation expenses, and budget for buying PC and servers. You have to provide everything you need for your work yourself. Besides, there's no guarantee that your income is stable. So you have to carefully plan how you earn and spend money. You should estimate your work at least 2 times higher than your past salary, okay? In my first freelance work, I failed to care about that. I was working at Yahoo Japan before I started my freelance career, and they paid me only $2,200 per month as a server-side engineer. I think it's significantly cheap, but that's another story. Then I quit the job and got the first app development work for a big company through a subcontractor. Now that I think about it, I estimated the price of the job at less than 1/3. It's an Android app that I worked on for 6 months for only $11,000. It's $1,800 on a monthly basis, and I did everything from building the server-side program to the client-side app. It was so hard, but I think it's okay for some reason. I was dumb. It was a big mistake and you should avoid this. How to avoid selling yourself too cheap? The most important thing is trust yourself. Don't underestimate yourself. When you think about how much you'd expect your clients to pay, your mind is significantly affected by your confidence. Your lack of confidence lowers the price because you want to avoid having responsibility for your work. You need to be enough self-confident by having successful experiences, as many as possible, so that you can propose the right price you would think, or you will never be able to satisfy your proposal. So just trust yourself and don't be afraid to raise your pricing. Knowing your market price also helps you decide your pricing. Make freelance friends and exchange information about how much they earn for their work. For example, an expert Ruby on Rails engineer is getting paid $7,000 per month in Japan. He's not just a Ruby engineer, but also has a knack for team management. The price would be higher in San Francisco. You can refer to those pricing standards for getting reasons for your pricing. Now you have both subjective and objective perspective of the price. Let's evaluate your work based on 4 criteria to make up your pricing, which are efficiency, and urgency, and specialty, and quality. I'm gonna explain each of them in detail. It doesn't make sense you charge less if you finish the work 3 times faster than others. For full stack developers, their advantage is that they need fewer communication costs because they, for example, can design UIs with code directly and they don't need mockups. They can build both server-side and client-side at the same time efficiently. This skill can significantly reduce costs and that should be considered as valuable. So it'll be nice to know how fast other people can work. I found I can build very fast by joining some hackathon events. Number 2, urgency. If you are requested to finish your work in a short time, you can charge for it. I have ever had the work to build an Android app that must be done in a week in the past. It's risky to accept such an urgent request because you might not be able to finish it. So you shouldn't get it unless you have very high confidence to finish it. Number 3, specialty. There are a lot of people who can build WordPress websites, so these kind of work are considered as a low specialty. On the other hand, building an image recognition system or recommendation system would require very specialized skill. That is, you can raise pricing for skills like them. It doesn't matter how easy it is for you, but it matters how many people can do the same thing. You should know, the time you spend learning specialized skills would be valuable. Number 4, quality. This type of job is interesting because developers make completely different results from the same requirements. The quality of output would vary depending on who made it. So the minimum quality of the result would be that it just works. From this baseline, you can add a lot of additional value, such as more attractive design, useful UI, and great SEO-aware design, fast API response, and useful features, things like that. But you need existing achievements to prove your quality so your clients can trust that your work will be great. In my case, my evidence that I can make a useful app is that I've made a music recommendation app that attracted over 130,000 people on the App Store. This achievement also proves my specialized skill to build a recommendation system using machine learning. An achievement is worth 1,000 words. With those 4 criteria, I made $70,000 for a contract job that I actually worked for only a month. It was 4 years ago. That gave me plenty of time to focus on building my own SaaS app. If I were to do a contract job again, I can get paid even more because I've successfully built a profitable product that greatly proves my work quality. So if you want to earn more income in less time, you should become more efficient, flexible, learn special skills, and accumulate great achievements to prove your work quality. So that's it. If this video is useful, please push the like button and be sure to subscribe to my channel so you don't miss more videos like this one. I'm publishing content about productivity, self-development, career, and so on. So thank you for watching. I will see you in the next one. Peace.